Now we're going straight to Boaz Warugu on the presentation of national values and principles of governance. Welcome, Boaz.
Thank you, Davinda. I will begin by reminding us of the processes that led to the new constitution. And I want to echo some statements which I think that was the third NCA, the National Convention Assembly, when it appeared that the more we wanted to move forward on constitution making, the more we had a lot of confusion. So I think it is Kepta who drafted that statement. the confusion making, so that we must be very careful that there are confusion makers and constitution makers. I think currently what we have is a similar situation. We have people who are keen on having constitution implemented, the constitution implementation, and then we have also the constitution manipulation. So there are manipulators and there are implementers. And this makes us really go off the mark on very critical issues, matters of the letter and the spirit of our constitution, which is actually captured in Article 10. Article 10 talks about the national values and principles of governance. And I know you have gone through that very well. I'm grateful that CRECO took it as a very critical area to try and do some basic baseline, some assessment to ascertain to what extent the public or the state officers, public officers, and the state institutions and the general public are in compliance with the provisions of that article. I think you'd realize that each and every move that the institutions created by the Constitution want to make is to go through it the normal way. It's just a matter of fact. I mean, let's just tick this box. Oh, we were supposed to do what? We were supposed to vet the serving police who were in post before the new constitution came about. So we are vetting, aren't we? That's a tick. What were we supposed to do again? Yeah, we were supposed to check the public land. I think Steve has dwelt more on that, to see that no more stealing or grabbing of the public land takes place. Are we doing that? Yes, we are moving from point A to B to C. Tick. A number of those tick boxes are going on. We have people who are keen on having constitution implemented, the constitution implementation, and then we have also the constitution manipulation. So there are manipulators and there are implementers. And this makes us really go off the mark on very critical issues, matters of the letter and the spirit of our constitution, which is actually captured in Article 10. Article 10 talks about the national values and principles of governance. And I know you have gone through that very well. I'm grateful that CRECO took it as a very critical area to try and do some basic baseline, some assessment to ascertain to what extent the public or the state officers, public officers, and the state institutions and the general public are in compliance with the provisions of that article. I think you'd realize that each and every move that the institutions created by the Constitution want to make is to go through it the normal way. It's just a matter of fact. I mean, let's just tick this box. Oh, we were supposed to do what? We were supposed to vet the serving police who were in post before the new constitution came about. So we are vetting, aren't we? That's a tick. What were we supposed to do again? Yeah, we were supposed to check the public land. I think Steve has dwelt more on that. To see that no more stealing or grabbing of the public land takes place. Are we doing that? Yes, we are moving from point A to B to C. Tick. A number of those tick boxes are going on. But the small survey that Craig rolled out would give you something very chilling. Because indeed, even as we speak about the implementation of the Constitution, not every one of us are actually aware of exactly what are we talking about. So let us not assume that the massive votes you saw on 4th of August 2010, that all those guys understood what this thing provided. I think the level of awareness about what this revolutionary document has is very low. And so even the standards that they have set are far much below what the national values and principles of governance are produced. The demographic survey that was released by the National Population Service, initially when actually it was indicating that a majority of our young people, actually to them, they are looking at every opportunity to get rich quick. Why? Because they value those who are wealthy, regardless of how they have acquired that wealth. And they tell you that we can vote, they can trust that person with resources because he already has sufficient resources. Unfortunately, they are not ladies. They are those who have massive resources. So in terms of what is, I imagine to be the national value system is different from what you have actually documented here. It's different from what you think integrity should matter. They tell you what? What is integrity? Do you eat it? It is not placed on the table, as ugali. You are talking about patriotism, that I sacrifice so much, and look at those who are now leading, what did they sacrifice? So essentially, I think there's an attempt, the justification, really to make you feel like these things don't matter so much. Nothing which is written matters any. Let's just look for ways through which we can achieve our own objectives. And I think if Craco would permit, when that report becomes ready, you'd actually look critically at how the perception that Kenyans have on compliance to these national values and the principles that are guiding us in governance, right from the key institutions of governance, the key independent offices, the public offices that have been created here, most of them are scoring less than 30% in terms of trust. A number of the people themselves also, even where it is as critical, including critical institutions like the ethics and anti-corruption, where I know most of you, those who are looking for state jobs, you require to be cleared and such, they will still wish to go and give a bribe. The so-called, is it certificate of bad conduct, or purchasing it from whichever level, that you go and buy it and they don't see anything really wrong with that. The elements of accountability, transparency, which to them, those are just words, because even including the public participation, which was embedded as a critical issue, that every process that leads to a delivery of a service to the public, where decisions are to be made concerning the delivery of services to the people, they must be involved. You would come across people who tell you, well, have you been involved? They tell you, oh, yes, we have. How? We attended a meeting that was convened. So, did you get feedback? No feedback. How are your views collected? No, we listened. So public participation becoming just a forum where you attend and disengage? Was that really the envisaged public participation as per the Constitution? I think the Steve had mentioned, Akoth had mentioned more critically as one of the three core objectives of the constitutional commissions, how these commissions help us to push forward the national values and uphold the principles of governance which we ourselves would trust and consider to be important. I think this is one area which all the team that would be spearheading this audit process within the constitution, we would advise that for each of those institutions, you look at them on the basis of the core mandate, because some of them actually do not have an idea. I think I don't want to take a lot of your time because I know what has been raised about having dinner. When the time comes, people start thinking about that. This an emerging trend about, and I think the suggestions which were emerging about the political education versus civic education. I wanted to say that we consider real political education very seriously, and not just political education and engagement. Let me tell you, good leadership does not drop like manna from heaven. And in fact, I think as we are doing this reflection, it's also partially an indictment on us that we thought by creating a very good framework, systems in place, there are institutions that would help us. So who are supposed to implement? When you do not prepare to go the whole hog, that's why you'll get the Langata Road Primary School and grabbers being within the presidency and telling you about issues of integrity. That is where you get people who are involved and mentioned adversely on extrajudicial executions, enforced disappearances, telling you about human rights and dignity. That is where you will get people whose only rise to wealth through the tenderpreneurship. They tell you, wanasema na kutenda, but tenderpreneurship, a case where they make you feel they are so wealthy, but the wealth is about the $6 billion deal done, and then they use just $100 million to splash all over. The rest of it is stocked there, and that is the tools in trade. I think you saw what the senator for Nairobi, the time when issues were being unearthed on where they would get most of the monies on the tenders that they were canvassing for. You get a tender, you get a cut, and the cut is huge, that the only thing you need to do is give political party X $10 million. They think you are next to Jesus. Give another influential person another $10 million, and you think they are close to you. And then, whenever you want to do some philanthropic work, mobilize the media to capture and see how you are good. You are a good-hearted person. I think these are things which we may need to keep the people aware about. So, political education should go with political engagement. I think that's what I wanted to summarize with. Thank you, and sorry for taking your time.